Can you imagine this? Can you take yourself into this place we call self, where no separation is experienced, where no separation exists, where all that is ever expressed from you is the love that God has for God's self, is the love that you have for yourself. For all you will ever know is God, and all you will ever feel is love. This experience does not happen within linear time. There are no steps to experiencing the love, the truth that you are, for what you are is eternal. So stop thinking that this experience will be delayed until a future time, and instead recognize that who you are, that the truth of who you are, the truth of what life is eternal. It is beyond the experience of time. Trust this, accept this, and begin to live it more in your life by returning to yourself, by relaxing into your beingness. Relax into the peace that you feel inside yourself. For what you feel in this very moment is always being expressed to the world around you. You may think that your family and friends, you may think that the people within your life are only aware of you because of the words that you share, because of the way you present yourself, because of the objects that you choose to surround yourself with. This is only a very tiny, a very minute fraction of who you are and how you express yourself to all of life everywhere. For the greater you is the vibration, the vibrational blueprint of yourself, that you are in each and every moment. So become aware of the fine essence of yourself. Become aware of the love and the truth and the power that you are, and express that more in your life by being it, not by forcing it, not by wishing it to come in some future time, but by experiencing it here and now, in this very moment, by relaxing into your true self. For effort is only needed to bring you back to the place of peace, to the place of love that you are. Effort is not needed to create yourself, for you have always existed. The true you has been created by God in the very beginning of eternal time. The true you has always existed and needs no energy of creation from the egoic you. The true you only needs experiencing. It does not need creation. So you may work with the light within your body. You may work with the energies traveling through your energy systems, and know that this will affect your blueprint. This will change the body's experience, the body's expression in your world. And this is beneficial. However, working with energies and working with light will not change who you are at the most fundamental level of your being. So you must once again return to an experience of yourself, return to identification with your true self, and you will no longer find yourself suffering because of the words of others, suffering because of the objections of others, suffering because of how others have treated you in your life. For you will know yourself to be beyond these impressions, to be beyond these relationships that exist in the subtle external layers of yourself. For these relationships that you have with other beings, with other human beings, with other animals, with other objects in your life, are only a tiny fraction of who you truly are. And when you connect with the truth of yourself, the reactions of others will no longer matter to you. You will not judge yourself based on how others judge you. But you must start in this moment by stopping the judgment of others, by stopping the condemnation of others, by stopping the gossip of others. You must stop creating from a limited egoic self, and you must start experiencing yourself beyond ego, yourself as pure peace, as total love, as universal awareness, as consciousness, as pure bliss, pure beingness throughout all time and space. For how you relate to the world, how you see the world, is creating the world that is coming back at you, that is coming back into your experience. So we urge you to begin experiencing everything as God. But you must start by seeing it as God, by treating it as God, by talking to it, by communicating with it with the utmost love, with the utmost respect. You must share with all of life all of the love that you have in your heart, that you have in your very being, without restraint, without exception. But know that love is not words. Love is an energy. Love is an essence. Love is life force. Love is an energy that is expressed beyond your words. Yes, your words can resonate with the vibration of love, for love can be a carrier frequency, carrying your words, carrying your thoughts and deeds into the world around you. And that will always bring back experiences of more love. For know that all of life everywhere is love. All you are experiencing is the love of God that God has for God's self. Know this. Experience the beauty that you are. Experience the truth that you are. Experience the love that fills you up so completely. Experience yourself as love. Experience all of life everywhere, as love.